Hello friends, welcome to the Cold War Prepper. This is Lee and welcome to the Prepper Pantry Haul for the week ending Saturday, June 3rd, 2023, as we're getting ready for whatever may be coming in the future. One of the things we did realize was we have failed to acquire replacement products for our cleaning products. And so we had a pretty good stash of disinfectant sprays and spray cleaners and all kinds of different things. And we just let that go and we didn't replace them as we used them. So we're going to start replacing something on a weekly basis today. And I don't have all of it shown here. I do have the Lysol disinfectant spray. We also got a bottle of spray cleaner, a bottle of laundry detergent, a bottle of dishwasher detergent. So we're going to be picking up stuff like that regularly now on a weekly basis until we get the pantry back up to where it had been at one time. So that was just negligence on our part. Continue to get candles, so one long burning, and this is basically down with the religious items at the dollar store. This was one that didn't have anything religious on it, just a long burning candle. Also picked up a six pack of emergency candles, and these are all 6 hour, I believe they're 6 hour candles. Let me see here. I think they're supposed to be 6 hour. We picked up some Tony Chachere's, red beans and rice, and then some jambalaya. Jambalaya will go extremely well with Fried Life's freeze-dried shrimp. And so that is on sale now, right now. It's a discontinued item, so there will be a link to my page for where you can buy Thrive Life. There are also some great May specials. You might want to take a look at that. Just take a look and go through like you're going to shop and take a look at the May specials. They've got some really good stuff on sale. I may do another video just talking about that. So the monthly sales. I almost canceled my normal order that goes in tomorrow. It'll be shipped on Monday. Because of some of the fantastic sales. But I said, no, you know, I've got a plan. I need to stick to my plan, regardless of some of the other things that may interfere with it. Picked up only 4 of the dog things. Dog food is getting in short supply here in the greater Austin metropolitan area, at least where we shop. And so I didn't find very much of that. We only found 4. I tried to get 2 of each flavor. And so that we were down from the 4 normal flavors down to only 2 flavors available. Picked up some instant soups, onion and beefy onion. That's going to be for a recipe we'll be showing you tomorrow. It's going to be beef and ground beef and onions and pasta and or rice. It's just a fantastic combination. Fantastic recipe I found. I put it in my watch list under. Helen just handed me the recipe. So I put it in my watch list, but this is what we'll be cooking tomorrow, the French onion ground beef and rice skillet meal. So, that's what we'll be cooking tomorrow. So I got some of that so we can try that. Then I told you last week, I think it was Little Lone Prepper found as a result of last week's Prepper Haul. She found these potato slices and banana chips on sale at Augustin Farms. I'll have my link to that down below as well. And they were all less than $10 a can, just phenomenal savings. Strongly recommend you take advantage of that if it's still there. Picked up a jar of salsa. Watching Rudy today on Alaska Prepper, he strongly recommended that you consider, if you have a solar system, that you get some rechargeable batteries and a recharging station. And then you can probably use that as a source of income in an SHTF environment. So we picked this one up and we'll probably try to get more batteries and see what we can do there. While I was at Dollar Store, they had this on the counter for $5. I said, what the heck? If nothing else, if it doesn't work that well, it could be a barter item. We did get more ammunition for the rifle as well as for the pistol. And then we got some elbow macaroni and I'll be opening that up and putting it into a container and vacuum sealing that. 2 cans of potatoes, 1 diced, 1 sliced, 2 cans of broth, 1 beef, 1 chicken, 2 cans of French onion soup. That goes with that recipe that we're going to be trying tomorrow, the beef, rice, and rice skillet. And then a can of chicken a la king, which goes fantastic over either rice or over egg noodles. Either way, it's just a phenomenal meal, and it will feed two easily. A can of beef taco condensed soup. Now that's so we can make taco soup or we're looking forward to that. A larger bottle of fuel for the jet boil system. Then, let me see what we are doing here. I get all that. Of course, rodent control, insect control is going to be very, very important in post-SHTF, so we try to pick up something for that on a regular basis. Got in some new books. So we got the Story of a Soul, the autobiography of St. Teresa of Lisieux. And then this is, I was watching A American last night. He and Walt Browning are the co-authors, and they had a live last night, and they were talking about Charlie's Requiem. And I said, I'm unfamiliar with that, so I decided to go ahead and order it. It's supposed to be kind of a parallel to the Going Home series. Helen finished one more jar of that tiramisu, so now I have another jar for candles. And then I just want to mention, in A. American's book six of the Going Home series, I think it's Avenging Home, he talks about Amron, AMRRON.com, and the American Radio Redoubt, ARR. So I looked into it. I went to the website. Fantastic website. Just great information. It also referred me to a book, The Partisan Operator Journals, Volume 1. And just a phenomenal book. As you can tell, I got it yesterday, and look what I've done already. So I'm about a third of the way through in one day. But it's got information on how to create CUIs, Communication Electronic Operating Instructions. And so that's going to be how you change frequencies and change call signs and how you authenticate single and double authentication. It gets very rudimentary into one-time pad encryption systems. I'll go into that a little bit further when I give you my series on encryption and encipherment. And those are two different things. Remember, I'm a code breaker by trade. That's what I did for my first 21 years in the Army. I was actually a 98 Bravo, which is a cryptanalyst code breaker. And then I became a 98 Golf, which is a voice intercept operator. So, and then my last 8-9 years was a 352 Charlie, which is a warrant officer, signals intelligence analyst, and reporter. So I really like what he's done with describing CUIs and direction finding and intercept and everything else in his book. And so we'll be adding that to our list of fiction books. I'm going to add it to my list of fiction books you must read, and we're going to add it to our list of books that we're going to do a book review on. So I hope this catches everybody very, very well and safe, and wish that everybody's just hunker down, stay safe. Down below, let me know what you're doing. What are some of your great ideas? As you can see here, I got this idea right here. This is because of some of the feedback we got the last week's video. So I really appreciate it when you guys add great comments like that. Remember that we're all in this together, so we can come out the other side together. Please be kind, polite, and respectful to each other, because togetherness is the key. And I look forward to seeing you on the other end. Take care. Bye-bye.